Hello there, YouTube. Welcome to Night's Arcade. I'm Sleepless Knight. We're doing something a little bit different today because today, sadly, is the anniversary of the passing of probably one of my all-time heroes and a man who influenced my writing heavily. I don't know if many of you know out there, but that's one of a hobby of mine. I've been doing it for a long time. I've written a novel and I have another channel that's all about slowly progressing towards publishing that and, you know, putting it online for free if I can get more people to follow it. But today we're all about the video games, and today's going to be a little bit odd because today we're going to be playing Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy 30th Anniversary Edition text game, which doesn't really lend itself to a video, does it? But because this is the anniversary of the passing of the late great Douglas Noel Adams, he died this day in 2001. So it's been a few years now. I do actually still remember when I find out that he died. A very, very sad day. I always describe him as the greatest person I never met, and I certainly miss him more than anybody else that I never met. But so it's going to be a little bit odd, and we're going to be playing the 30th anniversary edition of the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy text game. Now, this was released in 2014, which was the 30th anniversary of the release of Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. So today, this is the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, the TV show, that is. So you can find this on the BBC website. It's free to play if you really want to play after this. We're just going to delve into it for a few minutes because, you know, I can't really see a great deal of point in making like a half-hour video out of a text game, especially one that you can play for free yourself, and I'll put the link in the description. So here we are. You can find this on the BBC website. It says at the top here, the game's 30. I might have trimmed it a little bit because I'm just trying to zoom in a little bit tighter on the thing. I can't really get the interface to expand other than, you know, zooming in on Chrome. So I'll just do it in the edit. But it's the game's 30th anniversary edition. At the bottom it says, the word of warning, I must try to remember this. A word of warning, the game will kill you frequently. It's a bit mean like that. If in doubt, before you make a move, please save your game by typing save, then enter. You can then restore your game by typing restore, then enter. This should make it slightly less annoying getting killed all the time, as you can go back to where you were before it happened. So what we got on the screen here, 1984, 30th anniversary of the release of the game. You wake up. The room is spinning very gently around your head, or at least it would be if you could see it, which you can't. It is pitch black. So, you know, it seems fairly straightforward. I hope this is going to work. Oh, yeah, it is. You'll have to excuse my very slow typing. I am a writer in my spare time, but I never really learned to touch type. Like, I guess an awful... Oh, there we go. Lights are on. Good start to the day. Pity. It's going to be one of the worst of your life. Going to be the worst one of your life. The light is now on. Bedroom. In the bed. The bedroom is a mess. It is a small bedroom with a faded carpet and old wallpaper. There is a wash basin, a chair with a tatty dressing gown slung over it, and a window with the curtains drawn. Near the exit leading south is a phone. There is a flathead screwdriver here. Outside the bed, there is a toothbrush here. Outside the bed. Okay. Get up. Very difficult, but you manage it. The room is still spinning. It dips and sways a little. Okay. Put on dressing gown, because, you know, this is Arthur Dent. Make up. Luckily, this is large enough for you to get hold of. You notice something in the pocket. Check pocket. I don't know the word check. Okay. Something in the pocket. Pick up. Something in the pocket. In pocket. That sentence isn't one I recognize. Right, let's give up on that. Okay, put on gown. You are now wearing your gown. Pick up screwdriver, was it? You lunge for it, but the room spins nauseatingly away. The floor gives you a light tap on the forehead. Okay, what was the other thing? Now I can't remember. What was the other thing that was there? Toothbrush. Pick up toothbrush. Pick up toothbrush. It dances by you like a thing possessed. Okay. Get up. You're already standing. Floor. The floor gave me a light tap on the forehead. Did I immediately get back up? Did I get the screwdriver? Pick up. Screwdriver again. Dances by you like a thing possessed. We will. Miss the doorway by a good 80 inches. The wall jostles you rather rudely. Should we put save there? Oh, yeah, I must be signed in to save my game. So it's a good job we're not going to play this for very long, isn't it? I guess we're just going to play this until, you know, we can kind of go out. So what have we got? So here, in this window here, we've got like a cup of tea. This is the gown, obviously. This is the earth, for those of you not downward of kids. Or down with NASA or anything else. It does look flat there, but this is a two-dimensional screen. I don't want any flat earthers coming in here telling me the earth is... Okay, we're not going to get into that. So up, in, up, wait. So what do we... Oh, these are automatic commands. Go up. You can't go that way. Go south. Miss the doorway by a good 18 inches. Was there any tea? Did it say? Make tea. Oh, I love it. Brush teeth. You have nothing to brush your teeth. Grab toothbrush. Goodness sake. What am I missing? Check pocket. Hook in pocket. Opening your gown reveals a thing your aunt gave you, which you don't know what it is. A buffered analgesic and pot pocket fluff. Take that. Whoa, 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 whoa. After a few seconds, the room begins to calm down and behave in an orderly manner. Your terrible headache goes. Well, his terrible headache might have gone, but I've got one now because I didn't honestly know this game had sound in it, and now I know that. Oh, my goodness, that's dreadful. Okay. Pick up. Screwdriver taken. Take, I guess. It's a long time since I played text-based adventure games. A tree outside the window collapses. There is no causal relationship between these two events. Yes, but if you're familiar with Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, you'll know why that has happened. Leave room. Front porch. This is the enclosed front porch of your home. Your front garden lies to the south, and you can re-enter your home to the north. On the doormat is a pile of junk mail. Need mail. Oh, ow, ee, ow, 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 ow. That is loud. Oh, whoo. There are many pieces of mail. Most are from some computer company called Infocom, which wants you to buy their game. Infocom is the original publisher of this game. What does it say here at the top? Look, here we go. Infocom Incorporated. Hidden underneath is an official letter from the local council dated some 2 years ago and inexplicably not delivered till now, explaining that a demolition order has been served on your home. The date of demolition is today. Astoundingly, a bulldozer pokes through your wall. However, you have no time for surprise because the ceiling is collapsing on you as your home is unexpectedly demolished to make way for a new bypass. You are seriously injured in the process. But on your way to the hospital, a fleet of Vogon constructor ships unexpectedly arrives and demolishes the Earth to make way for a new hyperspace bypass. Better luck next time, next life. We're about to give you your score. Put on your peril-sensitive sunglasses now. Okay. I can't restore, can I? Yes, type of the name. See, I'm not signed in, so I can only restore public games. So, I mean, you know, I can restart. Oh, there we go. Okay, Hitchhiker's Guide to... Now I'm on a Vogon Constructor Fleet ship, I would imagine. Okay. Where am I? You're in the Vogon hold. An announcement is coming over the ship's intercom. Yeah, there we go. Check pockets. Should have a Babel fish in there. Oh, what in pocket? It's hard to open or close the pocket unless you're wearing the gown. Okay. Guards burst in and grab you and Ford, who come slowly awake. They drag you down a corridor to a large cabin where they strap you into large, menacing chairs. Captain's quarters in the poetry appreciation chair. This is the cabin of the Vogon captain. You and Ford are strapped into poetry appreciation chairs. The captain is indescribably hideous, indescribably blubbery, and indescribably mid to dark green. He is holding samples of his favourite poetry. The only line of that... I can... Oh, Freddled Grunt Bugly, I think is how it opens. And I think it ends with, or I shall rend you in the gobblewarts, see if I don't. I think that's right. Okay. Green. You begin to get a sore throat. Talk to Ford. You seem to be about to talk. Where am I? Okay. Use Babel fish. Okay. What do I have here then? Oh, that's the sub-ether signaling device. That's how we got aboard the ship in the first place. Toothbrush. What? No tea. I don't have any tea. Okay. So this is... Okay. Oops. Ah, right, yes. Okay. Hitchhiker's Guide. Use. That sentence isn't one I recognise. That's weird, because that's what the game's called. There was no verb in that sentence. I love this. This is awesome. I could do this. I could actually... I thought this is going to bore me to tears, but I could actually do this for quite some time. Let's just check. What can we do? There's no verb in that sentence. So, okay. Ask Ford where we are. Where am I? Okay. What lovely poetry. Listen to poetry. You have no choice. Why not relax and enjoy it? Okay, can I... Ford whispers, don't worry, I'll think of something. Vogon hold. This is a squalid room filled with grubby mattresses, unwashed cups, and unidentifiable bits of smelly alien underwear. A door lies to port, and an airlock lies to starboard. Your gown is hanging from a hook, and a towel is draped over a drain on the floor. There is a satchel here, resting in front of the tiny robot panel. Along one wall is a tall dispensing machine. In the corner is a glass case with a switch and a keyboard. It looks like the glass case contains an atomic vector plotter. The guard releases you and Ford and begins cycling the air in the airlock. Hey, guard, shouts Ford. Do you really enjoy this sort of thing? Shouting, stomping around, shooting people. Is it really a fulfilling career? Ha ha! thing. There was no verb in that sentence. No, I know that. So, what have I... That sentence is one I don't recognize. Read guide. Oh, consult guide about Vogons. So, consult guide about Vogons. There we go. Oh, look, and it appears here. You've got a little thing. Vogons, whose specialities are bureaucracy and planet smashing, are the most unpleasant race in the galaxy. They wouldn't think twice about throwing someone into space and wouldn't lift a finger to save their own grandmother from the ravenous bug-bladder beast of Tral. Also, see the entries on Vogon poetry and the ravenous bug-bladder beast of Tral. Ford continues trying to talk the guard into a sudden career change. Beethoven. Okay. I didn't think that was going to work, to be perfectly honest. It didn't seem very likely, did it? Okay. Consult guide about Vogon poetry. Oh, Cosalt. Oopsie. Vogon poetry. Oh. Consult. Did I spell that correctly this time? Consult guide about Vogon poetry. Vogon poetry is so awful that even the Sarcopsy of Berfon Smur 12, whose religion strictly forbids the taking of one's life, considers suicide a preferable alternative to a Vogon poetry reading. Talk to God. As if you seemed to be about to talk. So this is it. We're going to die. Oh. Okay. Apparently it doesn't know the word so. What are we? Flathead screwdriver. There was no verb in that sentence. Use. Screwdriver. Use. Why don't you know the word use? Your text-based adventure game that doesn't know the word use. You can't go that way. Okay. Put Fable Fish in here. Oh. Look for Fable Fish. Ford points at the outer door. In about 2 minutes, it will open and will be ejected into the vacuum of space. But don't panic, I'll think of something. Look around. This airlock has massive doors to port and starboard. Ford Prefect is here. Ford is mumbling to himself. Ask Ford what he is mumbling. You use the word what in a way that I don't understand. Listen to Ford. Ford produces a pencil and begins scribbling equations on the wall. Oops. Read equations. That's not important. Leave it alone. Oops. Ford's eyes light up. Do you still have the electronic sub-ether auto-hitching... At that moment, the airline would afford to blown out into space. Oh dear, your elbow must have struck some key on the Hitchhiker's guide because it begins droning out an entry. Coincidentally enough, the entry on space. If you hyperventilate and then empty your lungs, you will last about 30 seconds in the vacuum of space. However, because space is so vastly, hugely, mind-bogglingly big, getting picked up by another ship within those 30 seconds is almost infinitely improbable. Footnote 9. Precisely 29 seconds later, you and Ford are scooped up by a passing ship. Gasping for air, you pass out. You can hear nothing, smell nothing, taste nothing, see nothing, feel nothing. Look around. Look around. Okay. Okay. I beg your pardon, I beg your pardon, I beg your pardon. Okay. Or how you got there. Wait. Yes, I know that. I've done 102 moves. I don't have any awards. Go out. Out. Up. In. I'll figure this out. Any. Okay. What does that do? Oh, I see. I don't know the word. Yeah, okay. No problem at all. Ford. Okay. Consult. Oh, I don't need to write Hitchhikers, which is good because I always spell it wrong. About blackness. I'm not even certain who am I? Oops. Where am I? Smell nothing, taste nothing, see nothing, feel nothing. Smell nothing, taste nothing, see nothing. Okay. Listen. There you go. You hear the deep and distant hum of a star drive coming from far above. There is an exit to port. Okay. Go to the port. Okay. Oh, there we go. We were lying about the exit to port. You emerged from a small doorway. Entry bay number 2. There is an entry bay for the Heart of Gold. A corridor lies aft of here. There is a sales brochure here. This looks like that incredibly new Infinite Improbability Drive spaceship, the Heart of Gold, says Ford, with growing excitement. Announcement, announcement. This is Eddie. We have just picked up 2 Hitchhikers at an improbability factor of 2 to the 21,914th power to 1 against. Okay. Go aft. This is one end of a short corridor that continues aft along the main deck of the Heart of Gold. Doorways lead to fore and port. In addition, a gangway leads upward. Come on, let's look for the bridge. You follow Ford and eventually come to the bridge. This is the bridge of the Heart of Gold. A gangway leads down, and steam comes from an entrance to port. Next to the console, control console is Eddie, the shipboard computer. At the controls, apparently expecting you and Ford, are a man with more than the usual number of heads, the name Zaphod is stitched on his shirt, and a dark-haired woman holding a handbag. Both seem somehow familiar. There is a molecular hyperdrive pincer here. Hyperwave pincer. Okay. Where am I? You're in the bridge. Hey, Zaphod, how are you doing? Says Ford. He's cool. Not bad, Ford. Great to see you, replies Zaphod. He's cooler. You suddenly realize that the woman is Tricia McMillan. Call me Trillian, whom you were trying to pick up at a party in Islington just a few weeks ago, and that Zaphod is the guy she eventually left the party with. Odd. Well, folks, we're going to leave it there. This has been my tiny... It's been a bit of an odd video, I realise. It's a bit of a strange thing to watch and make a video of a text-based adventure game. But you can check this game out for yourself. If you want to play it for free, you can go to the BBC website and I'll leave a link down in the description. But this has just been my small tribute to a writer, one of my favourite writers of all time, possibly my very favourite writer of all time, and a man who's greatly missed and was an absolute genius. Douglas Noel Adams died May 11th, 2001. I'm still around, though. You can follow me on Twitter at knights_arcade. See what's going on in there. I'm in there from time to time. I'll be tweeting about this and various other things over the next couple of days. Tomorrow, I thought sticking more a little bit more with the Douglas Adams theme. We don't have a Douglas Adams game, but I thought I might start what's apparently supposed to be a very, very short game, if you play it correctly, so God knows how long it's going to take me, which is 39 Days to Mars. So we're going to play that tomorrow and do something just a little bit different. And we'll be back to more of the usual stuff the week after that. There's a Sidekicks video coming up next week. If you want to see that, subscribe, and anything else that I put up, subscribe to the channel. Leave a like if you liked this video. And ring the bell. Ring the notification bell, and you should, all things being equal, get a notification every time I post something to YouTube. So I hope you've enjoyed our little Douglas Adams tribute. I actually did make a Douglas Adams tribute several years ago, like a real-life Douglas Adams, like a live-action, if you like, Douglas Adams tribute video that was part of a series that I made years ago, which is on my other channel, and I'll try to put a little card on the end, a little video link on the end of this video. But other than that, I'll link it in the description below. Until next time, though, from Knights Arcade, this is Sleepless Knight saying nighty-night.